I'd like to talk to you a little bit about how you can use PI Coresight and the trending that's available to you. You've seen some of the ad hoc trends that we can do on the values and tables and things of that nature, but those ad hoc trends are locked to the time range of the display. And so what I'm going to show you now is how you can build your own trends with whatever data you want and really manipulate the time and the scale so you can see exactly what it is that you'd like to see. Now we're going to stick with our boilers that we've been looking at all day, and I'm going to take boiler 210 and drag him onto my screen and visualize him as a trend. Now remember, PI Coresight is going to try and automatically fit the data in your screen, so you don't have to worry about sizing or coloring or anything for any object in PI Coresight. It's going to automatically determine that for you based on what else you're showing. So because we didn't have anything else on our screen, this trend takes up the whole canvas. Now just like you could do with a table, you can actually add or remove values to this trend as you see fit. So if you'll remember on the table, some of these values never change, like the manufacturer. So just like with the table, all you have to do if you want to remove something is you click on the name in the legend here, and then you click on the little X, and that item will be removed from your trend. Things that are static, that aren't changing, I don't really need to trend them. So, and the equipment state, I'm not going to trend that either in this case. And the model number, I'm going to get rid of that. So now we have just the live updating data for this particular boiler. So you can see the legend up at the top. Each item is color-coded. Each item has a colorblind marker. So this is a filled-in circle, an open circle. This is a filled-in diamond, an open diamond. And so those markers are going to be on the trends here. Now what I'm looking at currently is an 8-hour trend. Remember, this is going to take the display time, so my trend is an 8-hour trend. One thing that you'll notice is the now button and the timeline are a very intense blue color. And that is one way that we indicate to you that we're looking at the current value, which means that when the values update in the PI system, they're going to update on your Coresight screen. Now, remember, PI does store that historical data forever, so you really can, once the data is in your PI system, you can go back and look at historical data very easily. There's a number of ways to do it. One thing I can do is I can actually scroll back in time with the scroll time window. So I'm going back in time. When I'm not looking at current time, you'll notice that the now button and the time window is a paler blue or a less intense blue. So now that's another way to indicate that we're looking at historical data. Okay, so I'm looking at 8-hour chunks. I can change that into other time ranges a number of ways. I can click these time window buttons. So if I want to see a 1-hour chunk instead of an 8-hour chunk, for example, that's how you could do that. We can go back to 8 hours. This is one day, a week, a month. If I go in that deep, going to be just a blur, so I'm not going to go that far out. But so you have some pre-configured time window buttons here. You can, with the scroll bar, we have handles. You can actually drag those handles in or out to hone in on the data that you want to see. You can click the now button. I'm clicking the now button to go back to current time. You can actually type in manually the time range that you want to see here. So you can do a custom time range. It could be an absolute time, like the beginning of the month, or it could be a relative time, like I'm going to do star minus 4H, hit enter, and now I'm looking at a 4-hour time window. And just like in all of our other clients, you can actually zoom in by just selecting an area that you want to see, and now I'm looking at 42.13 minutes. So that's kind of neat with the time range. Now one thing I can do if I found something particularly interesting is I can lock the time range on this trend. What will happen is no matter what I do from that point forward, however I change the time range of my display, the trend will be locked to the time range that I've selected. And the way you do that is there's a little padlock button on the toolbar of the trend. You just click that padlock button, and here he is. And so now no matter what I do, if I change this back to an 8-hour and I go back to the current time, you'll notice that the time range on my trend didn't change at all. I'm still looking at 1225 to 108. If I want to undo the time lock, I can click the padlock button and it goes back to normal. But let's go back and we're going to zoom back in and we're going to experiment with that padlock a little bit. Okay, we'll go in even just a little bit more. Alright, we're going to lock this guy. Now, let's say I want to compare boiler 210 to boiler 235. I know that they run similar process, but one's been performing better than the other, and so I really want to see how they compare. So I'm going to take boiler 235 and drag him onto my screen. Again, visualize him as a trend. And just like before, I'm going to get rid of the static data that doesn't change very much. Okay, so now these are both looking at the same time. You can see the timestamp on the trend. Okay, even though that one's locked, these are the same time. And I can pull my cursor across the screen, and as I do that, you'll see the timestamp for where I am on the trend, as well as you'll notice that on the legend, the values are going to update as I move my cursor across the screen. So this is one way that you can do some analysis on your data. But you'll remember that I clicked the padlock and I said, well, once you've done that, this trend is not going to change. So what happens if I go back to normal time? Okay, let's go back to 8 hours. Now, current time. So you'll see that the trend on the bottom was not locked, and he did reflect the changes in time that I made. The trend on the top stayed the way it was. Take a look at the cursors. This is what I find to be really interesting and a kind of an interesting way to look at your data. The cursors are in line with the timestamp. So as I scroll through 1108, 117, 116, and so forth, but they're moving at different rates because I'm zoomed in different ways on this data. So this is a really nice way for you to be able to do some comparative analysis between two like pieces of equipment and see, you know, how things are behaving. Or perhaps these can be on the same data, these two trends, and one's an overview trend and one's a zoomed in trend. But it's just different ways for you to visualize what's happening in your process and give you the tools you need to make the decisions you need to make. So that's a little bit about the time ranges in trending. What are some other things that we can change? I'm going to go ahead and unlock my trend here. And when I do that, you'll notice it took my 8-hour time window, so now these are in sync again, right? So I've shown you how you can manipulate the time, but you can also manipulate the scale. So right now, we have multi-scale, or show a separate scale for each trace. But if I wanted to show a single scale for the whole trend, I could do that by clicking this button here. And when I do that, now there's just one scale or one range, and everything fits in. You can't really see the detail on most of these, though, so it's not the way I wanted to see this information. So I'm going to go back to multi-scale. So that's one thing you can change. You can also change the upper and lower limits of the scale. And there's two options. Option A is the default, which means it's going to size the scale so that all the data fits. So it's going to be based off the max and minimum for the range that you've selected. So it's equivalent to auto range in Process Book. However, if you want a more static scale, you can actually pull in the ranges that are defined in the PI system for these values. And that's what this little button here does. So these are the defined max and mins for these values here. And you can see that changes a little bit how the data is rendered. So that's up to you how you want to visualize that. But those are some of the different ways that you can change the scale. And then, of course, you can change the time on the trends. You can use the padlock to really lock down what it is that you want to be looking at.